Hello and welcome to another tutorial. Today we're going to be focusing on brushes. There are three main ways to edit a brush. There's the actual brush settings right here, going from shape, size, hardness, density, step, rotation, opacity, blend mode, and all of them. There's also brush variance. It determines how the brush varies in certain categories like color blend, hue, saturation, lightness, size, opacity. According to either certain input values or a random jitter value. You've also got these down here which affect the scale and position edit information. The last thing that's available for editing in a brush is the actual brush head itself. I've got a few loaded in here already that I've got here. So today I'm going to actually focus on creating your own brush head. Now there are two ways to create a brush head. That is to either create it from an image or from a selection in an image. I'm going to go over here. I'm going to open. I've got a number of packs already here, like the leaf pack, which I'll open. Basically, in PaintShop Pro, a brush is nothing more than a grayscale image, where white is completely transparent and black is completely opaque. All grays in between, ranging from light gray to dark gray, determines how transparent something is. The darker, the more opaque, the lighter, the more transparent, and that's all there really is to it. You can get a number of these packs of brushes online, which are very helpful if you don't have the talent to make your own, like I don't. I'm not an artist, that's all I'm saying right there. So, I just zoom in on a brush, grab my selection tool, stop that. I need to learn to handle this better. Okay, I've got my brush head selected. Now I can either go to my file, export, and then, what's it called? It's called, well you can't see it, but it says custom brush down here. See if I can zoom in for you. If you can see that, yay! Yeah, custom brush. Or you can actually go over to your brushes, drop this down, and right here, zoom in here. This creates a brush from a current selection. This will create a brush from a whole image. So that's a nice difference to understand. So if you've got a selection that you want to turn to a brush, make sure it's that one right there. Okay, now that I still have my selection, right? Yeah, I still have my selection. Now I'm going to click that button. You can see I give it a name here. What is that? Is that a maple leaf? I'll just call it leaf one. I don't know. Now it gives you the option of setting a step and a save variance. Basically, if you haven't edited the variances at all, there's no need to save a variance. That's basically if you have it set up the way you want it and you want to save that. Otherwise, it goes straight to either the default or it will not affect the variance once you load it. Essentially, if you want to keep all variances, I suggest leaving that turned off. I always leave it turned off myself. I'm going to turn this up to 32. Basically, step determines how long it waits between brush strokes. Not brush strokes, but movement of the mouse is a time interval of some form between impressions of the image. Changing the step determines how close together or how far apart a brush draws things. Now, I have no right to call myself the author here, so I'll leave those alone. I'll hit OK. I should now have, not right here, leaf one. Da 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 da. Isn't that cool? I'm actually going to come over here to my image. I'm going to show you what a step of 32 looks like. You see, it's got little gaps between each draw. If I come over here and I lower the step, so that's important to keep in mind when you do it. It will give you a default step, and that's nice to have, especially with something like a leaf. And that's all there is to creating one like that. Right here I have an image of 500 by 500, which I believe is the maximum size for a brush. I'm not sure. You might be able to go larger, but this is the recommendation that was given to me, is at most a 500 by 500 image. So what we want to do is we want to create a brush really quick that we can use. What I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a regular brush here, and I'll go OK. I'm going to bring up the size considerably. I'm going to change that color. Okay, actually, I'm going to go over to my fill tool. I'm going to grab white and make sure I have a white background first. Then I'm going to go over to black. I'm going to go over to my paintbrush. I'm just clicking a whole bunch of times now because I forgot to turn up my hardness. Okay, so that looks nice. I'm going to go down to 1, try to center this. Do that, and that's going to be our brush right there. I'm going to go File, Export, Custom Brush. Now this one I'm going to call, I don't know, Hole. I'm just going to save it with the regular defaults. Back off here. Okay, come over here, find Hole. Oops, I gotta turn up the color. Ta-da, ta-da, ta-da. Very quick, very easy, very simple. I wonder if I could do like a... Apparently not. That's actually not a bad... brush there. I am surprised. It's the Olympics. Okay, so that's the end of that. Next time I'll try to get into the basic portions of the tools here and editing the brush variants for you. All right? Have fun.